Hi everyone, welcome to today's Wasabi Livestream lesson. It's Nikki. It's been chilly lately here in Japan. In today's lesson, let's go over useful winter terms in Japanese. And let's also learn how to conduct a small talk with the Japanese winter terms.
皆さんこんばんは、ミキです。今週も Wasabi Live Stream レッスンへようこそ。最近日本全国少しずつ肌寒くなってきましたね。皆さんの地域は寒くなってきましたか？今日は日本の秋冬シーズンによく使われる単語、そしてその単語を使った世間話のフレーズを一緒に勉強していきましょう。
First, let's take a look at different adjectives to describe cool and cold weather.
涼しい、cool、 肌寒い、chilly、and 寒い、cold.
To start a small talk, you can use this grammar pattern.
何々になってきましたね。
It's become. For example,
涼しくなってきましたね。
It's getting cool. It's getting cool.
肌寒くなってきましたね。
It's getting chilly.
寒くなってきましたね。
It's getting cold. If someone says these phrases, you could respond to them with the following answers.
何か最近変な天気ですね。
Somehow the weather has been strange lately.
Or, そうですね。洋服選びに困ります。
I agree.It gives me a hard time picking clothes for the day. Next.
暖かい格好。暖かい格好。
Warm outfits. In spoken Japanese, 暖かい becomes 暖かい to eliminate the trouble of saying to ta, which is called onbin. And onbin means that when a term includes two same letters,Its pronunciation changes for the convenience of speaking easily. Additionally, かっこ gets rid of う from the end, and it is pronounced as かっこ. Together, あたたかいかっこ transforms to あったかいかっこ to mean warm outfits. In a sentence,
現場は寒いと思うので、あったかい格好していきましょう。
The site might become cold, so let's wear clothes that keep us warm.
あったかい格好してってね。
This means please wear some warm clothes to go out. The original form of this sentence is
あたたかい格好していってね。
After applying onbin rules,
暖かい becomes 暖かい、格好 becomes 格好、
and をしていってね becomes してってね。Together, the sentence becomes 暖かい格好してってね to mean please wear some warm clothes to go out. The next term is
紅葉。
Which means red and yellow tinted autumn leaves.
最近は紅葉が綺麗ですね。
Those are very pretty autumn leaves.
そうですね。もう見に行きましたか?
I agree. Have you seen them already? Let's move on to the next noun used frequently in the winter.
ストーブ。ストーブ。Heater. ストーブ出しました。
I pulled out a heater. The term stove in English means the stove to cook, but in Japanese English, it means a heater.
ストーブ出しました。
Next.
小竜
is a Japanese traditional low, winter table covered by a heavy blanket that has a heater source inside to keep the legs warm.
こたつ出しました。
I pulled out a heater. Next.
着膨れ。
Kibukure is the term used to describe the situation where you wear too much because you're afraid of feeling cold and you end up looking like a snowman.
寒くて着ぶくれしちゃいます。寒くて着ぶくれしちゃいます。
It's cold, so I wear too much that I'm thickly clothed. The last set of terms are onomatopoeia.
Onomatopoeia.
We have covered onomatopoeia previously. These are words that imitate or suggest the source of the sound it describes.
もこもこ。もこもこ。
もこもこ is like a sheep fur that is very fluffy and dense.
もこもこの靴下買ったよ。
I bought these fluffy socks. While もこもこ refers to dense and fluffy feelings or texture, ふわふわ describes something that is also fluffy, but not dense, but soft, loose, and light like clouds.
ふわふわの綿あめ。
Fluffy cotton candy.
ふわふわの綿あめ。
So, ポカポカ is used to describe when your body starts to feel warm.
こたつに入ったのでポカポカします。
Since I'm in こたつ, I feel warm.
こたつに入ったのでポカポカします。
The last one is しんしん。しんしん is an onomatopoeia to describe the feeling of when snow falls quietly.When snow, the city sounds very quiet because the snow takes in all the sounds making the city like a soundproof music studio room.
しんしん is like the sound of snow falling quietly and peacefully.
In small talk, you might say,
雪がしんしん降ってる感じいいですね。
Isn't it a nice feeling when it's snowing quietly?
雪がしんしん降ってる感じいいですね。
That's it for today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed and learned winter Japanese terms and how to use them in small talk in this coming season. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next week. See you!
今週もわさびライブストリームレッスンをご視聴ありがとうございました。今日のレッスンの内容がこれからのシーズン、世間話などに役に立つといいなと思います。それではまた来週会いましょう。さようなら。